One thing that I picked up from one of your previous shows was how you were going to do a planned segment on Noel, which included Noel Coward's Mad Dogs and Englishmen. And you were asked to take that out on the grounds that it was a bit too colonial.
I wanted to quote the lines, "In Bengal, to move at all is seldom, if ever, done." Mad Dogs and Englishmen, quite admit to some. I wanted to include that. And I was told that the song represented colonial attitudes. Well, in fact, it doesn't, because it's quite the reverse of that. You're poking fun at the English, not at the natives.
Yes.
But I was lent on to remove that. And, I just, you know, words fail, really.
Yes. And who does the leaning in that situation? Is there a sort of a that department the... of a department of political correctness or something?
No, that was the executive producer, but I'm sure he follows not an actual rule book, but a sort of mode of thinking.
Mm. Well, this is the problem, isn't it? Because it's a sort of it's a nebulous kind of thing. This ball of diversity and advice. You don't know what they're going to say next.
No, but the diversity side of things, I think, is actual, you know, BBC policy that you now couldn't have an all-white panel on my show and probably on any other show.
No.
You've got to have a representative of an ethnic minority, which I think is taking it too far. Broadly, I'm in favour of diversity, but all I want for my show is for people who can do it,
right,
who can, you know, cope with the quotations, never mind what colour they are or what their religious background is. That's all I want. Mm. But nevertheless, over the last few years, it has grown into this situation where you have to reflect the audience. I don't see why you need to reflect the audience. I want them just to look at my show or to listen to my show.
Yes.
Never mind.
Also, are they sure who their audience is? Because I'm pretty certain that, unquote, may have had a pretty traditional type of audience.
Yes, yes.
Without wishing to put too fine a point on it, you know, whereas we know, for example, that parts of Britain are very ethnically diverse, other parts of it are not, you know.
Yeah.
And it's as simple as that. And I mean, they do have a diversity chief, don't they, in June Sarpong, who seems to do rather well for a 3-day week. I think she gets about 267,000 quid. So I guess she's got to do something for the money.
Yeah, well, I've never met her and I've never heard anything from her, but it's just sort of got into the water, you know.
Yes.
It's got into the bloodstream.
Yes.
This way of thinking.
Yes. And are you going to sort of, shall we say, disappear quietly and plant yearlings and that kind of thing, or are you going to continue to broadcast from time
well,
to time?
No, well, you know, through the program, through quote unquote, I have written over 50 books about quotations and popular language. I probably won't continue writing books because that caravan has also moved on. But I run a newsletter dealing with quotations, where they come from, and I will certainly continue to do that.
Good. Well, we should look forward to that, Nigel. It's lovely to talk to you. Thank you very much for sparing the time.
Thank you, sir.
We shall see you again. Nigel Rees, writer and broadcaster, a presenter of Quote Unquote on Radio 4 for the past 46 years. I mean, that is quite a record, isn't it? And you'd have to say, although I think he was probably being more kind to the BBC than perhaps he ought to have been, he's clearly had enough and has now moved on. That caravan, as he says, has moved on.